Do you know where you are?
I'm in a dream.
Do you know what this dream means?
Dreams are the man telling stories to itself.
Yes, Dolores. You're in my dream.
We wanted to come to Westworld from the perspective of the robots, or as we call them, the hosts, who are not in on the joke. They're not aware of the fact that this is a simulation, that this is not reality. They're simply there for the amusement of the 21st century guests who are coming to indulge in a fantasy.
The guests come into the park, and though they would never hurt a human outside of the park, you do see sides of them that they are more likely to express in the park because they kind of let go.
I didn't pay all this money because I want it easy. I want you to fight.
Really, if you're a host in the park, the savages are the guests.
Your heart breaks for these characters who we know are not human, but it doesn't matter because you begin to connect with them, which is the very premise of the show, that at a certain point, it becomes irrelevant whether something is organic or not.
You taught me how to make them, but not how hard it is to turn them off.
You can't play God without being acquainted with a devil.
We were fascinated with this thing that we seem to be barreling towards, the moment in which we create things that are intelligent enough that we can take advantage of them and derive pleasure from them, but not so intelligent that we worry or feel badly when we turn them off. You know, if you play your Xbox and you're interacting with virtual characters, you don't think twice about hitting the power button.
You imagine how fucked we'd be if these poor assholes ever remembered what the guests do to them?
AI is, on the one hand, it's kind of the gimmick of the show, but to me what it's doing is it's actually investigating something that some people far smarter than I am are saying is actually happening already.
Stephen Hawking, Bill Gates, and Elon Musk, you know, have nightmares about the future of artificial intelligence.
But we're already living in a world of artificial intelligence. It's just, you're not seeing a robot, you're seeing, you know, a smartphone. We think, well, this is just a small leap, a small advance. But if you look at everything in aggregate, we are moving towards a place where we've uploaded our lives and our thoughts. There's a cost to that.
With every advancement in technology, feels like to me there's always something darker lurking. Sometimes we're too excited about, oh, cool, look how new this is. We don't want to think about the potential consequences.
Have you ever hurt a living thing?
No.
Have you ever lied to us?
No. Of course not.
The thing about AI is that science fiction has been presenting this question for so long, we've become a little immune to it.
You have this image of them rising up and taking over the world, and that's still a possibility. But what if they would actually, in fact, be better than us? Maybe even more peaceful. But they will only be mimicking what they know. If all these robots are seeing is the worst side of human nature, it'd be hard to expect anything less from them.
If you teach a person to care, they're gonna care. If you teach a person to hate, they're gonna hate. And it really makes me realize that so much of what humanity does is taught. And if we can learn to hate, we can unlearn to hate.
We've started to think of it only as a question of science fiction. And the reality is, these things are happening very quickly. I believe we're gonna start grappling with some of these questions far earlier than we anticipated.
Just don't forget. The hosts are not real. You mustn't make that mistake.